Bound by Flame is a mess. It's a mess with high-minded ideas, but it's a mess all the same. By the time the game comes to a close, it's clear that there's a wide gulf between the experience you just had and the vision that inspired it. Bound by Flame is a fantasy role-playing game about choice. The game presents you with narrative decisions now and again that affect faction allegiances and spawn conflicts, most of which can only be solved through swordplay. The star is a mercenary called Vulcan. He, or she, if you choose a female avatar, finds himself sharing his brain with a growling demon. Vulcan's mind becomes rather overcrowded as a result, but at least the demon grants him the ability to conjure fire. Bound by Flame's most intriguing choices are those that see you deciding whether to bend to the demon's whims or assert your humanity. The more you side with the demon's advice, the more you take on demonic traits. As I faced the final battle, I had 3 sets of curled horns growing from my blackened head, and my voice had taken on a diabolical rumble. The consequences of these decisions aren't just cosmetic. Growing horns, for example, means you can't wear helmets, though you do gain enhanced magic power regeneration by way of compensation. There are other trade-offs as well, but mutating into a fiery fiend is nonetheless a delectable experience. There are choices to make in Bound by Flame's story that have nothing to do with the demon within, but the game's poor dialogue and bland acting aren't apt to make you care about anyone's fate but your own.
Well, your Ice Lords have never messed with a Powder Master, now have they?
If you listen to the rabble who actually live in the swamps, we should head back to the village now.
Characters are introduced one after another, and many of them are available as battle companions. They have tales to tell if you ask them, but bare-bones writing communicates only the essential information without fleshing out the people sharing it. Over time, narrative problems compound so greatly that you can no longer take anything seriously. Transitions from gameplay to cutscenes are jarring, with characters repositioned instantly. The tone seesaws wildly, with your conversation partners cracking jokes at the oddest moments, and Vulcan suddenly acting like a jerk for no apparent reason. When the final hours asked me to make a sacrifice, I made the decision arbitrarily because none of this insanity mattered to me. Your companions aren't just boring, they're also useless in battle, often falling in a matter of seconds. Combat is Bound by Flame's biggest problem, though the fighting is initially pleasing. You can switch between various stances that let you use a formidable two-handed weapon, wield a pair of daggers, or sneak around and take undead enemies by surprise. You can also toss fireballs and infuse your weapon with glowing flames thanks to your demon friend. Vulcan's muscular swings give combat a nice sense of heft, and the game's skill trees let you customize your fighting style in sensible ways. Bound by Flame then proceeds to ruin its promising combat with a series of choices that suck out all the fun. Small areas are overpopulated with ice spirits, lurching archers, and other enemies with ridiculously large health bars. Throw into the mix a companion that you can't revive in the middle of battle, an unreliable target lock, incoming attacks that always cause interrupts or knockbacks, and a camera that can't always frame the action, and you rarely find a good fighting rhythm. Combat then becomes a matter of exploiting defects, not one of finding a proper tempo. You circle around bosses for over a minute until your health replenishes. You run away from battle so that your companion will come back to life. And you try your best not to lead enemies from their aggravatingly small leash ranges, lest they return to their homes and regain all their health. You can help things along by placing explosive traps and getting your parry timing down pat, but battles remain a drag all the way up to the excruciating final boss. In between battles, you might pursue the game's few side quests, all of which send you back into the same bland corridors in which the main quests occur. You may also check out the game's crafting system, which is its most robust feature. Various elements can be combined to make useful items, like health potions or to bolster your equipment. Refreshingly, you can stop to craft at any time, even in the middle of combat. By RPG standards, Bound by Flame isn't a very long or expansive game. If you don't consider the battles you must repeat, the adventure is around a dozen hours or so, and there's no true world to explore, unless you consider a few medium-sized levels made up of narrow hallways to be a world. Bound by Flame has a lot of ideas, but never gives them room to grow.
Fear not, my young friend. I don't eat elves, They play havoc with my digestion. So you're not at any risk from me.